We were made, all of us, we were made to walk with God. We were made to be filled with the Holy Spirit. Now notice the name of the Holy Spirit. His first name is Holy. He's holy. He's holy. God is holy. We forget that sometimes in the modern church. God said in Leviticus, I must be regarded as holy by those who draw near me. See, he's holy. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 15 and 16, God says, be holy in all your conduct, for it is written, be holy, for I am holy, says the Lord. Amen. Hebrews 12, 14 says, pursue peace with all men and holiness, because without it, no one will see God. Now, the wonder and the marvel of the grace of God is that God's grace through the blood of Jesus, the Word of God, and the Holy Spirit can take us and make us holy. God can make a cranky person sweet. He can. It's happening to you and me. How many is it happening to? How many are less cranky? Most of the time. It's the grace of God. He's changing us. God can make us holy. Now, God will make us holy, but he won't do it and cannot do it apart from our cooperation. We cannot make ourselves holy. God makes us holy. We cannot do it without him. He will not do it without us. We have to cooperate. So he said, if we cleanse ourselves. Now, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, let's look at this. We are bound to give thanks, verse 13, to God always for you, brethren, beloved by the Lord, because God from the beginning chose you for salvation. Again, when we see the word salvation in the New Testament, it does not mean what we think in the Western church. We think salvation means they came forward at an altar call, prayed the sinner's prayer, they are saved. Well, kind of. You're saved from hell, but you still need to be saved inside. You're saved from the penalty of sin, but we're being saved from the presence and the power of sin through the process of sanctification. So when the Bible talks about salvation, it means justified. Justified means I'm not going to hell. Sanctified means God's getting the unclean, impure, unholy out and imparting the pure and the love in. Okay? That's still salvation. That's why the apostle said, we who are being saved. We're being saved. So he said, God chose you for salvation, to be justified, sanctified, glorified. He chose you for that by the Spirit and belief in the truth. That's how we're changed. By the Holy Spirit does the work of sanctifying us as we believe and act on the truth.
Amen.
Okay? We don't act on it, we don't believe it. So he said, to which he called you by our gospel for the obtaining of the glory. So God's, the process of sanctification happens by two things. The work of the Holy Spirit and us believing and responding to the word. When we believe and obey the word, the Holy Spirit comes in and changes us. If we say, I believe, but we don't obey, he can't change us. Jesus said, follow me and I will make you. We have to take the steps of obedience to his word. And as we do that, that doesn't make us holy, but it puts us in a place where his Spirit works in us and changes us. So we have to have obedience to be sanctified. Hebrews chapter 5 verse 9 says, Jesus became the author of eternal salvation to all who obey him. No obedience, no sanctification. Agreed? No obedience, we don't obey God. But when we obey, the Holy Spirit works in and through our obedience and transforms us. It's how he works. That's why the false grace says just believe. You don't, doesn't matter if you sin or don't sin or whatever, because you're covered by grace. That's a false, that's a distortion. That's not the truth. The real grace teaches us to deny ungodliness and live soberly and righteously in this age, looking for the appearing of the Lord, who redeemed us from every lawless deed that he might purify for himself his own special people, zealous for good works. That's Titus chapter 2. The grace of God teaches us to deny ungodliness, live soberly and righteously in this present age. Teaches us how to obey God. Then he empowers us. We're to work out our salvation, Philippians chapter 2, verse 12, with fear and trembling. And verse 13 says, because it is God who works inside you both to will and to do. We have to read, believe, and take steps of obedience. Then God works in us to empower us to do it. And we're changed. Amen. So we're not changed apart from obedience. Amen.